pretty nasty place, but he was happy because ogres like nasty.
On his birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
Always best. Take your spot over there by that sign. No, that's too far. Too close. Ah, just right. Wicked Witch.
Life is never ending.
Peter Pan.
Vanished from the town.
Bad habit.
Drag from the town.
Three fish. Mama Bear.
Mama Bear, Mama Bear, Mama Bear, they ridiculed my hats. They said that we were fat. They labeled me a fashion mess because they wore a granny dress.
Park it there, Wolf.
Story of my life. Looted from the ball. The party's off the hook. That's the story of my life.
And if you find me back in the kingdom, you will be executed. You read the stories.
You mean those stories that say I'm a big bad wolf?
or the stories that say I'm a wicked witch? Or those stories that say I'm a wooden boy?
What? I'm not a wooden boy. I have a glandular condition.
I'm gonna spell it out for you. You're the only one tough enough to stand up to that no good flim flavor Farquaad.
All right, fine. I get it. Attention all fairy tale things. I'm gonna go see this Farquaad guy right now, get you all off my land and right back where you came from. This can't be right. I'm all turned around. Let's see. To the left at the candy house, then past that weird old woman in a shoe. Then I took a right at Mary's little house of lamb chops.
Ah! Help me out, would you? I'm being chased by goons.
Ah!
Oh, you idiot!
Well, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Shrek, and let us at it.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die. I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
It's a talking donkey. A freak of nature. As are you, you unsavory beast.
Hey now, you're going the right way for a snack now.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I'm authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? Boom! This is the part where you run away.
Ah!
And don't come back. Now, which way to Duloc?
Can I just say, that was incredible. Man, they were tripping over themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Oh good, I'm glad. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now there's a shocker.
That's funny. Say you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to find the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc! I know Duloc! You gotta let me show you the way, because I'm like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like me do. Hey, didn't you hear what they said? Man, this place is going Stepford. We gotta join forces, otherwise otherwise they're gonna lock me up and I cannot go back in a cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I had 6 years in solitary for impersonating a pinata.
Okay, look. Only because I'm lost, you can on one condition. You keep the jabbering to a minimum.
You got it. No jabbering, man. You will not regret this.
Too late.
But that's what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey. Two snot-wart friends off on a whirlwind big city adventure.
Into
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but the tiny hat definitely does.
Okay. Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yeah, the one with all the fairy tale creatures in it.
Newsflash, Yoga. That swamp is actually within the province of Duloc, and therefore, my swamp.
Now look here, half pint.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. This is too perfect.
What is it?
You. You're big and bulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner. Great and noble quest.
Oh, where are you on a quest?
To get my swamp back.
And you've nearly accomplished it. All you need to do is rescue Princess Fiona from the tower and bring her back here for me to marry in the deed she puts in your name. But I give her in the following her royal highness. My people, I shall make this Princess Fiona my queen, and we will finally have the perfect king.
Sounds like the perfect time for a flashback, doesn't it?
Who are you talking to?
Nobody. Let's go rescue a princess.
Thank you.
him.
For your information, there's a lot more to ogres than most people think.
Example.
Okay. Onions. Ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yes, but no.
They make you cry.
No.
Oh, you leave them out in the sun and they turn brown and start sprouting little white hairs?
No. Layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions. You get it? We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. You know, not everybody likes onions.
Parfaits. Everyone likes parfaits. And they have layers. Have you ever met someone and you said, hey, let's go get some parfaits? And they say, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits would be the most delicious thing on the whole planet.
You know, this may turn out to be the longest day of my entire life.
Ooh, I got the perfect drug for that.
Oh no, I am not interested in anything that you have.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you got to go somewhere. Cause the fun is getting there, yeah. Oh, what the heck, I must get this up on the road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail, forget the maps, forget the guide. Before you know it,
toss her shades and locks her doors till you found a
to get your eyes checked. Secondly, that princess is not even my type. Not my type at all. Because I like my girls tall, lean, and curvy. So I hope you learned something valuable here today. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll be on my way. What's the matter with you? You got something in your eye?
No princess, but he wants me. No great beauty, but he wants me. No one ever, 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 ever wanted me.
So
snoozers. Wake up! Are you Princess Fiona?
I am. A waiting knight so bold as to rescue me.
That's nice. Now let's go.
But wait! Sir Knight, I have long awaited this day, and I would as first like to know us the name of my champion.
Shrek?
Sir Shrek, I pray that you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks. Now let's go.
Now hold us on, Sir Knight. It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Jeez, I'm like a crackpot magnet.
You didn't slay the dragon?
It was on my to-do list. Donkey!
Shrek! Dragon! Run!
This is how I picture it. More or less I must admit, a puppet in my world. Oh, I love a blue start. I knew this day would come, and you would find your way. Unless my dream comes true, what do I do?
Princess? We could use a little help here. Really? Nothing? Best day ever!
It would be today!
Did you see that? Did you see that? Shrek here from an accident right there in that tile castle floor, and then bam! He cut this rope, and this rope hooked this old gossip-looking chandelier, and that chandelier fell right on the dragon, and that's how we escaped the fire-breathing dragon. Who the man, Shrek the man!
You did it, you did it, you did it! You're amazing, you're wonderful, you're a little unorthodox, I admit. Thy deed is great, thy heart is pure, I am eternally in your debt.
And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
Did you hear that? She called me a noble steed. She thinks I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle's won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
And why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please,
I would have liked to look upon the face of my rescuer.
No, you wouldn't this.
But how you kissed me?
What? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No! It's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight and they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? You think that Shrek is your true love?
What's so funny?
Let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take it off.
I'm not going
to. Take it off.
No.
Now!
As you command, Your Royal Highness.
Ogre?
What, were you expecting Prince Charming?
Yes, actually. Oh no, I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love, not some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, Princess, we were sent to rescue you by Lord Farquaad. He's the one who wants to marry you.
Then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. You can ask him when we get to town tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We need to make camp.
Camp? But you've just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to find someplace to rest immediately.
Well, that's unfortunate, because we're going to keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now.
Oh, great. There's a cave right over there.
Shrek? That's no place for a princess.
No. It's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
You want me to read you a bedtime story?
Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems nice. You want me to read you a bedtime story?
Say good night, donkey.
Good night, donkey.
Change your tune, mister.
Hey.
rehearsal good morning, men.
You're awful, Chipper.
And why shouldn't I be? It's a new day full of promise and fresh starts.
It is?
Yes. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior yesterday. Obviously, we got a phone log, but and I'd like to make it up to you.
You what?
You did rescue me after all, so I gathered a basket of berries for the trip, and I made you eat your daisy chain! We got a long journey ahead of us to Duloc!
If you say so. Come on, follow me.
Oh, road trip? Yes! Punch buggy!
Ow!
Well, tell me a little bit about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let me put it this way, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in a short supply.
Really?
Oh yeah, but he's a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet, very good at small talk.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just saying you might want to lower your expectations a little bit. Like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. It doesn't bother me. Not after today, not after a lifetime of misery. Things are finally going my way.
Oh, it must have been really difficult in that dragon garden tower of yours.
It was.
It must have been nice to have a roof over your head and a cozy bed to sleep in at night, which was more than I had when I left home.
Are you really comparing yourself to what I endured?
I'm just saying, you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
The things you don't know, you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What, you run out of shampoo a couple times?
I mean, about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy? Are you kidding?
I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Army cut a hot plate and a chamber pot, and every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation out the window, isolation in my bedroom, and Mary's little head. 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. All the walls and days were added. Happily those walls were padded. So I think I got to be. I think I got.
That was a sad story, but life was better, I'm just saying. Red things were plain. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had her up for like a time. A moment torches burn, my princess even scorches. You're just waiting. I had a flaming hiding. As I fled, I had to wonder if our victorious thunder wouldn't overcome the heaven. Did I mention I was 7? So, I think I got you to be, I think I got you to be. Yeah, 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 I think I got you to be, I think I got you. Oops, better out than an augment, say.
You gotta burn the heat, you gotta burn the pan, you gotta make a move and call me.
morning. Why not? I spent my whole life without true love. What's one more night?
You must be hungry. Here, try one of these. They're called snothers. They're a little bit like s'mores, but instead of chocolate and marshmallow, we use squirrel desserts and mulch. Ah, they just melt in your mouth.
Shrek, I know you can't hear me right now, but if you could, I want to say a few things to you. I'm in your corner, buddy, but you've got to tell this girl what you really feel deep down. You may not get another chance, so just go on now. Just open up your heart, and...
Oh, your best.
Yeah, who's Shrek? Who's gonna tell her?
Well, I...
Oh, she can't take this!
Well, I'm... I was wondering.
Okay.
Well, I was wondering.
Spit it out.
Are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you?
Even if I did, and I'm not saying that I do, she's a princess, and I'm...
An ogre?
Yeah, an ogre.
She needs to know what you're really feeling deep down.
Where are you going?
To get her firewood before the fire dies.
My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love.
Thank you.
You don't have to tell me anything. I heard enough last night.
You heard what I said?
Every word. Especially, who could love such a hideous, ugly beast?
But I thought that would matter to you.
Yeah, well, it does. Ah, Princess. I brought you a little something.
Whoa, that a broomstick horse. Princess Fiona?
As promised. Now about my swan?
Cleared off as agreed, and the deed has been put in your name. Now step away before I change my mind. Sorry for sassing you, Princess, but I am Lord Farquaad.
Lord Farquaad, forgive me, for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that is sweet. But you don't have to use perfectly manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
You're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, I ask your hand in marriage. Maybe the perfect bride for the perfect groom.
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would make me excellent.
We'll start the plans for tomorrow away.
No. I mean, let's get married today, before sunset.
Oh, anxious are we? You're right. There's so much to do. Guard right ahead and tell him it's code red. We'll be married by sunset.
What I miss? Fare thee well, ogre. Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting her get away. Look, there's something you don't know. I talked to her last night.
Yeah, I know you two talked last night. You're great pals, aren't you? So why don't you go and follow her home?
But I want to go home with you.
Me? No. I live alone. My swamp and me. No one else. Especially useless, pathetic, annoying talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah, well, you know what? You thought wrong.
Just when you think life can't get any worse, you get evicted from a swamp.
Well, look who it is.
I thought you were going to help us.
Instead, you have us kicked out.
Yeah, well, what did you expect from an ogre?
We believed in you.
Ah, grow up.
I won't grow up.
Then get out of my way.
Well, there he goes again, pushing everyone away. Just like you did to me, and just like you did to Fiona. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion boy. You're afraid of your feelings.
Who's Fiona?
Mind your business, Hatter.
She's the princess who loves him.
Ooh, there's a girl.
Now it's getting interesting.
The princess loves him?
Loves me? She said I was ugly. A hideous beast. I heard you and you two talking last night.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about, somebody else.
She wasn't talking about me? Well, then who was she talking about?
Oh, now he's interested. 2 seconds ago, he was like, don't talk to me. Go away. I don't need that.
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid ogre. Which is why Princess Fiona and I can never be together.
Listen up, ogre. We spend our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
Thank you. I do.
And do you, Princess?
I do.
Stop the wedding!
What? Rowan showing up uninvited with creepy friends. You.
Fiona, I need to talk to you.
Oh, now you want to talk. Well, it's a little late for that, so if you'll excuse me.
But you can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's only marrying you so that he can become king.
Fiona, that is outrageous. Don't listen to him. God, take this abomination out of my sight.
No!
I mean, let's hear what the monster has to say. It might be worth a laugh. Oh, you are awful. You have an ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible.
Okay. Well, it's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, then maybe you won't mind the view. Tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now. I'll let it in. I'll tear down the wall and clear a spot for you.
Thank you.
before.
Well, this explains a lot.
Ew. It's disgusting! Hocus pocus, pocus, alters nothing. I have my crown, see? That makes me a king. Now as for you, my dear, I'll be locked back up in that tower of yours for the rest of your days.
Actually, no, you won't. Farquaad, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine.
And a very handsome puppet.
Okay.
And half a dog. And a witch. And a big
Thank you.
icon blows down.
Life is but a witch hunt.
Mama's in the mud, mama's in distress.
They ridicule my hat, they sense of you a fat. They call me a fashion mess because I wore a granny dress. Seriously, they're in love with song.
Oh, good.